Rochelle.
Hello, beautiful people. Yes! I always count the guys in the audience.
How many did you find?
Six, yes.
Welcome to the show, everybody.
We have a fun show today. My buddies Will Forte and Kristen Schaal from Last Man on Earth are here.
And we have the very lovely Rochelle Aytes from Mistresses. Ooh. And my good friend, Cynthia. A Hollywood summer glow makeover with celebrity hairstylist Kin Paves. I know. And celebrity makeup artist Christina Zilber.
But before we get into all of that, let's talk about sex.
Okay.
More specifically, sex after marriage. See, what just happened? Let's talk about sex. Yay! Let's talk about sex after marriage.
Well, really? Okay, we found this list. It says the 35 honest thoughts when asked about sex after marriage. And people were posed with the questions, what happens to your sex life after you say, I do?
We don't.
No. So you're saying on national television that you're not getting enough marital consensual sex.
No. Don't get me wrong now. Let me clear this up, okay? First of all, fellas, okay, the six guys in the audience. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Is there, thank you. Is there such a thing as enough sex? No, exactly. So that's where my we don't come
from. Here are some of the things. It's like ordering your favorite ice cream. You know what to expect every time. Hard to come by.
No, but hold on
Impossible.
A second.
Impossible. We have six kids. What do you want
from
me?
Well, kids mess it all up. That's true. You know, micromanaging.
Somebody says infrequent, yet still obligatory.
Okay.
You didn't marry your roommate, so you got to keep it a priority. That's very true.
Yeah, that's not
Ooh,
a good
look
thing.
Look at this one. Someone said, well, for us, it just gets better and better.
Yes! There you go. That's the spirit.
Do you think it's gotten better and better after 10 years?
Okay, look. I'm so putting ourselves on Front Street right now. This is the truth. It's like when you first get to know each other, you know, you're dating, there's still this awkwardness and
right.
You're not comfortable and you want to know what the other person likes and you don't know if you can really express what you like and you're afraid of being judged.
Well, don't whip out the handcuffs on the first day.
Exactly. You know, the hot wax and all that stuff.
Okay.
Not that I like it. I'm just saying. So after a while, we've been married for 10 years now.
Yeah.
So now I can throw away the instructions. You know what I mean? Now I know what I'm dealing with. Now you know what you're dealing with. It's comfortable. It's good. It's... I like it. That's all I'm saying.
Okay, America, just so you know, there is sex after marriage. Yes.
Don't you worry about a thing. Well, there's a couple of tricks that we can share, right?
From okay, our I think we're taking it a little far. They
no,
get it. We don't have to tell them what
I'm
we do.
I'm not talking about techniques. I'm just saying in
okay.
general.
Okay.
Let me just talk to the guys, okay?
Okay, talk to the six
guys. Take a shower. You know, that helps, right? Take a shower. You know, you always want to be ready. And date nights help.
That's true.
If you don't have time for date nights, date hours.
Yes.
Date minutes. You know what I'm saying? Cater to your woman. Very important.
Like now,
that's one thing that has been overlooked. For example, just little things, little text messages to check in on her.
Oh, I like that.
Yes.
Like when we were boyfriend and girlfriend.
Yeah, flowers.
Yes.
Flowers always work.
Surprise gifts, like a nice tote. I'm just saying.
You're starting with the tote again? You said
let
it go.
Let me fix your microphone. Little things like looking out for each other.
There you go. See?
Straightening this tie.
Thank you, baby.
Yeah, maybe I should just do that for you.
All right, see? No, seriously though, catering has been... Okay, baby.
Sorry.
catering has been sort of overlooked, you know, because you have to, you took her off the market. And ooh, she took me off the market, so you have to cater to the woman, cater to your man. You know what he likes, you know what she likes. Cook a meal for him.
Right.
There's nothing wrong with that, cook a meal. I know you're exhausted, but cook a meal for him, right?
Okay, we get it.
Take her out to the movies, take her out to dinner. Cater to your people.
Okay.
All right, I'm just saying. Because, you know, you both were individuals and you led happy lives as individuals. And now you come together and you have to compromise. You have to learn how to accept, how to respect each other. So, yes,
there's a little list here. You know, we have a great research team and they came up with a list for us. Create a habit of positive greetings. You know, that's true, because when he was my boyfriend, I used to run to the door like you were the last Mohican. I would be like, oh, hi.
I know, I remember that.
Now I'm like, is that you?
No, not even. I'm at fault as well, because, you know.
Yeah, I'm going to start jumping for joy when you come home. Yes.
I call it the daddy parade. I need the daddy parade when I come home.
Yes, but from the mommy.
Yes.
Yes.
And you know, I work on a computer, and when she walks in, you need to shut the computer.
And
you
up.
Need to take her in.
That's a good one.
There's the queen that is walking into the room.
Yes, that's a good one. That's a little thing, guys.
Guys,
yes.
It's a little thing, but it's a big thing.
It's a little thing, but
you know,
a big thing.
When you pay attention to that, and you take her in, and she walks into the room, and you go, oh, there is my queen.
Yes, yes.
You have to make it do it with a smile like that.
And the hand, okay.
It does wonders.
Okay, what about this one? Have at least 2 minutes of undistracted communication every day.
2 minutes?
Yeah.
What is that? Like 2 minutes? Are you serious?
Yeah.
We're setting the bar very low. I mean, if you can't pay attention for 2 minutes, you shouldn't be married.
You know what? I'm gonna start right now. I'm gonna say thank you for bringing me my coffee exactly the way that I like it in the morning. Thank you for turning the bed down at night on my side. And thank you for trying to fold the laundry right.
Whoa. Hey, no, don't clap for that. I don't buy that. Look, there's some compliments that are honest and that are genuine, and then there's compliments that men hate.
Oh.
Okay, don't start the cute thing and the, oh, you're so cute as you're trying to fold the laundry. Let me do it over again. I know how to fold the laundry. I have a list of my own. Here's a list of compliments men hate, okay? Number one.
Oh, it's so sweet you want to help me clean up, but I can do it faster myself.
I'm amazed you were able to fix the leaky faucet. You're the only person I can talk to.
You're so cute.
Okay, ladies. It's patronizing, it's demeaning.
What about that one? That's funny.
Oh, really? It's like you're my thorough child, but I love you anyway. You're laughing, huh?
I'm sorry, it's funny.
Have you heard the secret to a long life from 113-year-old Bernardo Lapallo?
Bernardo
Lapallo from Arizona. 113. Now, he's never been sick one day in his life.
Not one day.
And he credits his diet of fruits and vegetables and no red meat.
Wow.
That's tough, though.
Yeah.
You want to commit to that.
He also eats garlic, honey, cinnamon, dark chocolate, not milk chocolate, and olive oil.
Yep. Garlic is high in vitamins B, B6, C, boosts immune system.
Yep.
Chocolate? Did you say chocolate?
Yes, not milk chocolate.
Okay, well.
Not chocolate ice cream.
It's high in antioxidants, high in fiber,
yes,
iron,
all
magnesium.
That. He wrote a book.
He wrote a book called Age Less, Live More.
We love that.
Very good.
He'll be 114 in 3 weeks.
That's crazy.
Happy birthday.
Well, but then again, if he's 114, he may not remember being sick because it was so long ago. So I don't trust that all
this
the way.
This is so amazing, though, really. I mean, we don't celebrate this. What do you think we'll be like when we're really...
114? Well, you know, there's an app that'll show you what you're going to look like at 100.
Okay.
Let's see.
Ooh. Wow.
Ah, look at my saggy cheeks.
You're still fine, though.
I have like 700 teeth in my mouth still. I don't know if I can believe that. What about you? Let me see. Whoa. That looks... You're beautiful.
Pretty
Thank
Look at her at 100 years old.
The light is still in our eyes.
Wow.
Hi.
Hey, you got all your teeth. How did that happen? That's amazing.
We have to take a break, but we'll be right back with Will Forte and Kristen Schaal.
We're up next on the Boris and Nicole Show.
Our first guests are two people who have been on the comedy scene for years. They're even able to make Total Isolation hysterical. From the hit Emmy-nominated show, The Last Man on Earth, give it up for my friends and co-stars, Will Forte and Kristen Schaal. Perfectly coordinated color schemes.
We call each other every night, and we make sure that we go over what clothes we're wearing the next day.
Yes. Well,
I can tell.
Yeah.
It's Which beautiful. Is tough because we don't know what our mood's going to be the next morning. So
yeah.
we could say, you know, olive earth tones, and then we could want neon the next morning.
Right. So you have to double check the next day.
Yeah.
I
get it.
I do.
You both look really lovely.
Thank you. We coordinated.
Yeah. A little bit. We put effort into those things sometimes. Yes.
We pray on it. We pray on it, and then we get the message about what to wear.
Oh,
yes.
Jesus tells you. Mm-hmm. You've got good taste.
Well, you grew up in a religious household.
Yes.
Yes, and you do all this great comedy now. And like, how did your family deal with it?
Well, they're very supportive, and I think they're just happy to let the Lord shine through me in any way He can. Maybe that's with a taint monologue. Maybe that's what the gross sex scene, but, you know, at least it's making people smile.
Yes. Because you had a very intense love scene with my husband, yes.
Yes, I did.
Yes.
It wasn't intense, it was just very passionate.
I was really nervous about it, and then Boris was like, don't worry, I do this all the time.
What?
You said that. You said, this is how I met my wife. And then you said the whole thing was to make the lady feel comfortable because you don't do anything.
you're right. But what did it do? It made you comfortable.
I felt instantly comfortable.
There you go.
I was like, okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
It was probably the most passionate love scene, craziest love scene I've ever done in my life, for sure.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
We were.
About your life.
We were so loud. It was incredible. It was a lot of fun.
I'm not gonna,
But you guys have had love scenes together.
That's how we met.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Many love scenes.
Yeah, and it worked out.
Well, we the first day we worked together, we had a huge, gigantic love scene. Uh-huh. And that sort of set the tone for our relationship.
Yeah, that broke the ice.
Next 15 years. I've been trying to live up to that every single day.
Is she like, cut? Yeah.
In real life, all the time.
Yeah. We need to revisit the foreplay, bro.
She actually directs me.
No, don't, guys. Yeah. Your show is about Last Man on Earth. Yes, it's a great show. Yes. Will, if you had to repopulate the world with one person, who would it be?
Well, I mean, no disrespect to you, but I think I would pick you, Nicole.
You would pick her?
Just for proximity sake. She's married. Oh, I guess you're married as well.
Yeah,
well, I guess, I guess both of you guys would be great.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I know.
So I'd pick either of you. But and then, you know, and then I guess I'd start going outwards if you guys said no. And, you know. No, you know, there's, yeah. Well, a lot of, yeah.
It would certainly be a challenge for me to accept that. We'd have to talk about it.
We're going to have a lot of time. We'd start up in a couple weeks, shooting the second season of the show. Woo! We can negotiate.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Good deal. What about you, Kristen?
Well, I would say my husband, obviously, but if he wasn't around, I would probably pick Neil deGrasse Tyson. Because I just think those genes should be spread, you know, far and wide. I would be happy to spread them.
I want to pick again. I'm going to pick Neil deGrasse Tyson. Yeah.
Well, you just talked about your husband. You met him on The Daily Show.
Yeah.
What was it like working with him?
It was great. He's a wonderful man. Oh, that's us.
There you go.
That's my wedding dress, actually.
Is he trying to bite you?
Yeah, I don't know.
Or is he just yelling at you?
Yeah, we were just happy to be together. hamming it up. But yeah, so we write a lot together, and it's great. It's fun to work with your spouse because you know that you can always make time because they're living on top of you. Because I'm too busy to write. No, you're not. I know your schedule.
Well, I want to just get into celebrating you, Will, because in all seriousness, you're pretty amazing. Because you wrote, co-created, and you star in The Last Man on Earth.
Yeah. Thank you. Not only that.
You've been nominated for 2 Emmys. Yes.
Give it up for 2 Emmys.
That's
incredible.
I get very excited about, you know, kind of stuff.
It's very exciting for my family because they put up with so much disgusting stuff that I've done over the years. Like, it's like me running around with a stick of celery in my butt for MacGruber. That never happened. There's
Emmy. Outstanding writing, a lead actor in a comedy series. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
That's amazing. Well, these guys.
Where were you when you were found? I have like fantasies about being nominated for anything, for something. So I always want to know, where were you when you were nominated?
My buddy from high school was getting married in France. And I was actually at his ceremony. They were just about to the you may kiss the bride part. And I was picking up my phone to take a picture, and I got like 30 text messages. And I said, this is either something really good or something really bad.
Oh, yeah.
So, and it was the good part.
It was the good part.
So did you interrupt the...
Yeah, I said, wait,
hold on a second.
I just got nominated for an Emmy. Oh, no, two. No.
Now you can kiss the bride.
I told my mom, and my mom wanted to, you know, can I tell people? And I said, Mom, this is their wedding day. Let's just not worry about it.
She told everybody.
We're in France, so we're drinking quite a bit of rosé. And she told a couple of people by the end of the night.
She's proud. That's good.
Yeah. Oh, she's the best.
We have to take a break, but more with Kristen and Will after this.
Are you supposed to be on now? We're supposed to be on the Boris and Nicole show now.
They're waiting for us right now.
But just we'd right rather now. Make this video. Yeah. We'd rather be with you.
They can wait.
This is more important.
This is very important.
Phil?
What are you doing, Tony?
Just going about my customary business in my own house.
Why don't you go put some clothes on?
Well, isn't that the pot calling the kettle black? Or African-American? Or American?
What are you trying to say?
Well, you took off your shirt yesterday, and now suddenly being shirtless is a crime?
I was about to take a shower.
Well, I was about to take a shower, too. That's what I came to tell you. So we're even.
Now I know.
Now you know.
Now I know.
Now you know.
Hey, guys. Oh, my God!
Erica, good die. I'm sorry. If I had known you were coming, I would have tucked it in.
Oh, I kind of thought you already did.
As if. I know you didn't think that, but I love that old Australian sass. Well, I will get out of your hair and your bald head. Look, the U.S. Constitution. Been meaning to frame that. We the people.
I love it. Did you guys know this show was going to be a hit? I mean, it's such an offbeat comedy. It's brilliant, but you know, it takes a minute to click in to the American psyche. I mean, did you know that it was going to be such a huge hit?
Oh my God, no! I go into everything I've ever done thinking that it's not going to do well, and usually I'm proven right. So it was very exciting when people actually watched it. It was. I got to say, in watching that clip though. It makes me, it's so hard to ever be in a situation where you take off your shirt after you friggin' have to watch this guy take off his shirt in a scene.
But you know, let me just tell you, I'm having the best time with you guys. I mean, I'm having the best time shooting the show. These guys are so funny, you have no idea. Well, you do have an idea because you've seen the show. But anyways, Last Man on Earth combines romance with comedy. And since we love to play games,
yes,
we are going to play a romantic comedy game. We're gonna team up.
Okay, you and I switch.
Okay.
Kristen.
Hi.
Kristen and I are gonna team up.
Okay,
and
yes. We have some props here.
Don't take this the wrong way, Will. Here, this is just for the game.
I understand. respect.
And since we work really well together.
Yeah, we do. We have great chemistry.
That's right. We actually
we did almost host this show like pretty easily.
Oh, it was like second nature.
Yeah.
It just flew out of
this
us like that.
This could be the Boris and Kristen show.
Easily. No, easily. I mean, we have a clip. Check out the clip.
Crafty hands. What's that there? Are those little kitties?
Yeah.
I'm a cat man myself.
Love cats. So cute.
Yeah. Thanks for this cup.
Well played, Carol. Well played.
Well, back to the game.
Okay. Oh, thank goodness.
Each team will have 45 seconds to act out as many romantic comedies while the other team guesses. Each correct answer gets 1 point, and the team with the most points at the end of the round wins. Will and Nicole, you're up first.
All right.
Yep. Okay, now don't.
Okay.
Okay. Here we go.
We got this.
Okay, pick one and go.
Oh, hello. My name is, Oh, my God. I'll have what she's having. Yep.
Okay.
Oh, man, I have been up for 400 hours.
I know.
Just cannot go to bed.
We live in a state above California.
We've lived in
Seattle.
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. 400
hours?
Okay.
Marriage.
Hello.
Oh, Princess Bride.
Wow.
Okay.
You're like
Sugar, I keep picking the bad ones. Oh, my God, I don't have a...
Clueless.
Yeah!
Oh, my God.
Okay,
it looks like you got four right. Now it's our turn.
You guys did great.
Thanks.
You guys were great. Okay.
All right.
We just needed a practice round.
Yeah. Okay, ready, set, go.
Okay. Oh. Say, boomba.
Say it again.
Yeah.
Wow, that was really okay.
Nice.
Oh.
Oh, well, you.
Ring, ring.
Booty call.
I got some of that. Yeah.
Oh, man.
Okay.
I'm just gonna, and then we're gonna, and then we're gonna.
Lemon basketball.
Yes!
I saw if we almost did that one.
Oh.
Oh.
Pretty Woman.
Pretty Woman.
Yeah. Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, there's the thing. How do you, ding. Answer the mail, and then you can, oh.
Oh.
She's got mail, okay. You've got mail.
Yeah.
Yes.
But that doesn't count. They don't get that point because
okay.
He said mail.
You get
Dr.
married.
Dr. Zhivago.
The best man. That was the best man.
Oh.
Okay.
So what's the score?
It's 4-4. It looks like we got a tie. Whoa.
Everyone's a winner.
We want to thank Will Forte and Kristen Schaal for being here. Don't miss season 2 of The Last Man on Earth this fall on Fox. We got to take a break.
Now, we ladies love to get a new look. And now that the warm weather is here, it's time for that Hollywood summer glow. We called on superstar celebrity hairstylist Ken Paves, who styles Victoria Beckham, Eva Longoria, hopefully I'll get in his chair, and beauty expert Christina Zilber. Thank you both so much for coming. They're here to give a few women some celebrity-inspired looks. So, yes, let's welcome Ken and Christina again, because they're doubly fabulous. And the reason I'm acting like a little weird is because I don't want to see their big reveal. So, Ken, what are some of the quick tips that you can share with us to change your look?
Well, changing your look, especially for summer, is similar to changing your look for sex after marriage. So makeover to change it up, and that's good. Change it up, ladies. Keep your man interested. Woo! But for summer, what's really big is texture. Texture is huge. So whether it's your natural texture, braids, twist, and then also color's amazing, and then cutting is a real great way to change it up.
And what is your most requested celebrity hairstyle?
Well, my most requested celebrity hairstyle is one of yours as well that I'm a huge fan of, but short hair. Victoria Beckham's very short hair is my most requested celebrity
She's
style.
She's super fly. Christina, how can everyday women get a summer glow?
I think the easiest way to get a summer glow is with two products, bronzer and highlighter. This summer, it's all about strobing. Strobing is the buzzword that is like taking over the makeup world.
Tell us really where to put that strobe, because I did it before and I look like, like a robot in a way.
You don't want to look like the Tin Man.
Exactly.
You want to put it right on the areas of your face you want to stand out. Your cheekbone, high on your cheekbone, your brow bone.
Yes.
Inner corner of the eye.
Gotcha.
Maybe down the bridge of the nose.
A little pop there.
A little bit of the Cupid's bow.
Yes, that little area right there. That's awesome. Many of you wrote in for help with your summer look, so I decided to hook up three of our viewers with a Hollywood Summer Glow Makeover. Let's see what both of you did. Now, our first person is Crystal. So let's see Crystal's before photo. Beautiful. Now, before we see Crystal's reveal, what did you choose to do with her look? Like, who did she want to look like, inspired by?
Well, these are all celebrity-inspired looks. So the thing I think when you look to a celebrity-inspired look is look to somebody who has hair texture similar to yours. So we went to someone I'm a huge fan of, Janelle Monáe.
Woo! Yes. So let's see Crystal now.
Wow.
Ken, what did you do? I didn't know you could get down with the braids like that, Ken.
Nice, right?
Absolutely. The real deal.
Well, thank you. The cool thing is about doing braids, and braids are really huge for the summer, is what we wanted to do was create a style of braids so she could actually wear them down, wear them in ponytails and all different styles, and then also create something this elaborate, but something she wear for, you know, this style for quite a long time, in and out of, you know, different styles, like I said, and just something that looks really organic to her.
Yes, Crystal, how do you feel?
I feel beautiful.
You look beautiful.
Yes. I mean, her makeup is flawless. Tell me what you did.
So we wanted to line her eyes with a little black liner, give her that smoky eye, give her a red lip. But what we did is we used highlighter strategically on her cheekbone. Do you see that high on her cheekbone?
Yes, that little pop.
So we really brought out her cheekbone, and we also put it on the Cupid's bow, which is a great way when you're wearing red lipstick to kind of contrast that little highlight with the red lips. Gorgeous.
Gorgeous. Flawless. Crystal, do you think you can keep up with this? Is this something you could do?
Yes, I can keep up with this look with the help of my sister.
Yes. Such a yes. Well, thank you, Crystal. Our next makeover is Jilly. Let's see Jilly's before picture. She was inspired by
Julianne Hough.
Ah,
so really important, too, with her hair as well, though, was even though she was inspired by Julianne Hough, make it relevant to her hair and her texture. Their hair is very different, so.
Let's see Jilly now.
Woo!
Amazing. So tell us about her hairstyle. What did you put layers in? Is that a flat iron?
We put a lot of
curl?
Layers into her hair because she has very heavy hair. She has great hair. We cut off a significant amount, a lot of, quite a few inches. She was down about 5 or 6 inches, but really layered this to give it kind of aeration and texture to enhance her natural texture.
And how did you get that beautiful beach wave in the front?
That's kind of based on her natural texture. I'm a huge proponent of letting hair air dry. It takes a lot of less time out of your styling routine, and then just did a light tonging on top of her air dry texture. It makes it a lot easier. It's better on the hair.
That's gorgeous. That's a huge color change for you, Jilly. How do you feel?
I feel like totally new, like new person.
Oh, wow. Christina, that baby pink lip is all that and a bag of chips. Please tell me about that
so
lip.
So pretty. Well, we didn't want to compete with the hair. The hair is making a big statement in itself. We did a smoky eye in gray, not too heavy, not a black smoky eye. We did a gray smoky eye with a little hint of blue in it. Soft cheeks and a baby pink lip with gloss. Lots
High
of gloss.
Gloss. Yes, gloss, it's gorgeous. Gloss. Thank you, Jilly. And our last makeover is Robin. Okay, let's see Robin's before picture. Ken, tell us about Robin.
Robin was inspired by Scarlett Johansson and her short haircut. And I think that every woman should have short hair once in her life.
Yes, I had short hair too. So let's see Robin now.
Oh my gosh.
Ken, what did you do to Robin's hair?
Well, you know, Robin has amazing hair. She has a lot of fine hair. So what we wanted to do is keep it short, but anything but suburban. So we kept it a little bit more modern and cool by keeping the front long and really cutting into the back for these great kind of, you know, rock and roll layers all throughout.
Yes, it's edgy and
it's
fun.
Sexy, not
and
suburban.
Yet she can still pick up the kids with that hair, too, and go out to
and
the club.
Man.
And the
Absolutely.
Man.
Absolutely.
Christina,
hair to be sexy.
What did you do for Robin? It looks gorgeous.
With Robin, because she has that little edge, we wanted to keep her makeup soft and fresh and just keep it really great, light for the summer. So we put soft pink on her cheeks, soft peachy pink on her lips, and
a
soft
pop of
eye.
Shine on her nose there?
She definitely has
yes.
a little strobing on her nose, on her cheekbone. It's the summer glow.
It's gorgeous. Robin, how do you feel?
I feel amazing. Yeah. Like 20 years younger.
Thank Celebrity
you.
Stylist Ken Paves and his team, thank you so much. Beauty expert Christina Zilber and her team for creating the Hollywood summer glow for these well-deserving women. And one last thing, everyone in the audience is going home with some Jouer cosmetics that gives you that beautiful look from Christina. And and thanks to Ken Paves, you will all beginning, you are beautiful, nourish, and hydrating serum. Yes. Thank you so much. For more information on Ken and Christina and these beautiful looks, check out our Facebook page. We'll be right back. Housewives of Atlanta, but I know her as my good friend. Please welcome Cynthia Bailey.
Little girl, she's not little anymore, she's 16.
She's 16.
So she, you told me she started dating?
Well, not
How
dating.
How in the world do you deal with that?
Well, you know, here's the thing. She's about to be 16. You know, she isn't really dating. What we do with Noelle is I try to...
Is that what you think, or is that...
No, she's not dating. I know that she's not dating.
Okay.
But we do, like, double dates. Like, we actually just went to the movies together on a double date. Peter and I and her friend.
That's
and
so
they
sweet.
Went to one little drive-in part, and we went to the other, and then we were, like, texting, like, hey, what y'all doing? You know, you guys done? Like, you know.
Are you serious?
Yes.
What advice are you giving her? Like, now that she is going to be entering that world, and, you know, I'm just curious because, you know, I'm taking notes as I go. Getting ready for Sophie.
Well, you know, we live in a different time than when we were coming up, and I think the key to a success, to raising kids successfully is all about communication. It's all about giving them information. You know, you can't lock them in a basement until they turn 21.
Why can't
you can, but you may be arrested.
Yes.
So, you know, I just try to, like, you know, keep the lines of communication open and make her feel she can come to me for anything. So we're close. We really, you know, have a very close relationship. You know, dad's great too, but she really needs her mama.
Yes.
So,
does.
You know, I have to make sure.
Because you're her model how to move around in the world.
Yes.
But you have a lot going on. You got the Bailey Agency, and now you have a new baby.
I do.
Your line of sunglasses.
Yes, Cynthia Bailey eyewear.
Whoa.
So fly.
I mean, if you guys follow me on Instagram,
you've
seen me post about it.
I've known you for 20 years, and I always think that I'm keeping up.
Oh, yes.
With what's going on with you, but this is
new. Well, you know,
new.
It's always, yes.
Wow, look at
that. Yes. The
the beautiful Nicole, Ari Parker.
Can you say
Kodjoe.
South of France?
Now, those look great.
What style is this?
Picked up these for you.
Oh, really?
These are called my Noels. Speaking of Noels.
Oh,
yeah,
I like
these. Are my Noels.
Okay, is this the Noel, but in a different color?
Yeah, this is the color? One. That, yes, this is the tortoise.
Over there.
I have these in mind for you, Boris.
What are these called?
These are called my Baileys, after my little Pomeranian.
Well, they need to undergo a little name change.
Well, I have some Boris and Nicole's on there.
Because now they call the Kodjoe.
Yes.
These are kind of fly.
No, that's you. They look amazing on
really
you guys.
Comfortable.
Don't they look very comfortable?
They're comfortable.
Very comfortable. And, you know, for me, you know, for the Cynthia Bailey brand, it was all about affordability, but quality.
That's how much important. Do these cost?
These are $145, yes. And these are $120. But wow. Don't you feel the quality when
I
you put them on?
I do feel the
like
quality.
You just feel all that quality, right?
They make me breathe better.
I know, it totally set your whole outfit off.
Yes.
Like, I'm not even kidding. But listen, today only, for your
goes?
Beautiful audience and all the viewers, you can go to CynthiaBaileyEyewear.com and you can buy one, get one free.
Woo!
Yay!
Thank you, Cynthia.
You're
Thank
welcome.
Thank you, Cynthia Bailey, for coming.
You're
Check
welcome.
Her out on The Real Housewives of Atlanta. And for more information on her glasses,
I'm Rochelle Aytes, and I'm here at the Boris and Nicole Show. You don't want to miss this segment. I'll be talking about mistresses and my engagement. It's going to be awesome.
Our next guest is one of the stars of ABC's hit show, Mistresses.
Ooh.
Yes. She plays single mom April Malloy in the provocative romantic drama. Take a look.
Floor seats. Hello, Mr. Fancy.
Perks of being a headmaster at private school. Laker kids. Any chance I can interest you and Lucy in joining?
Me and Lucy?
Unless you think it's too soon to include her. I don't want to rush that step. I know it's important.
I don't think we're rushing. I think it feels right on time.
Woo! Please welcome the beautiful and talented Rochelle Aytes!
I'm all
You know what that is?
Yes. I sit right here? Okay.
You know what that is, Rochelle? She
What's
came out
that?
Like, oh, yeah. That's because you just got engaged.
That's yeah. What it is.
And he's here.
Where is he? Where is he?
There he is. Congratulations.
Wow. Responses on social media when you posted about it.
I did not expect it, honestly. And he wanted to post it like right when he
look
proposed.
At this. Right here. We have
I was no hair done, nothing. I mean, it was just
where were you guys?
We were on the coast of Oregon, and the place was called the Proposal Rock. So he had it all planned out, and he wrote it in the sand and
wow.
Got on his knee.
And you were completely surprised.
We never talked about it, so yeah, I was totally surprised.
The place was called Proposal Rock?
It was.
Wow, I've never heard of that before.
Me either. Yeah.
Very good.
There's a lot of guys.
Did he tell you that, or is that true?
It's true. It's true.
He just added
then
to
I
the
saw
story.
A sign. There was a sign that I missed on the way. He was like, please
was
don't
handwritten?
Let her. Please don't let her see it.
He's such a dream
okay.
crusher.
Okay,
I know.
Okay, okay.
You're awesome.
No, I love details.
Let's talk about mistresses.
Yes.
Not that any of them are in your future. You are going to forget about that. But the title alone speaks volumes. What are some of the misconceptions about the show?
Well, the main misconception is that the show is based on women who are dating married men. And that's it. Or that it's a reality show. But it's not. It's a film, a show about women who are friends who are just dealing with different aspects of relationships and drama, and it's sexy and it's fun. And my character's never been a mistress, actually.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
That's awesome.
So what does CJ think about you playing on that show? What do you think?
CJ, you need to just come on down
yeah.
here.
Oh, come on down
here. Down here, CJ.
Come on.
Yes, get on down
oh,
here.
Oh, my God.
Come on down, CJ.
Yeah.
Come on down, please. Congratulations, brother. Have a seat.
Yeah, so
There he is.
Wow.
See,
welcome,
your tats match her dress. That's awesome. Same color.
We coordinate well.
How did you feel about her in this role? Did you have any issues with love scenes?
It's work, you know, and I'm proud of her and everything that she does. And, you know, the bottom line is if you're secure in your relationship, all those other things just, you know, fall into place.
Fall through, son. Yeah. That's beautiful.
He has no problem with it.
I understand. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just work.
Yep. Would you guys ever work together? CJ, you're an actor too.
I would love it.
Yeah. Well, we didn't work together like in the same scene, but he is in Mistresses. Coming up next week, he plays a detective.
Ooh. Well, let me just give you a piece of advice, you know, about working together.
Uh-oh.
You know, when you're living together, you eating together, you sleeping together, you're working together, just, you know, I'm just, you're with a, yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you for that advice.
Rochelle and CJ.
I know what just happened.
Be sure to watch Mistresses Thursdays on ABC.
We'll be right back. I am so sorry.
That's all we have time for today. We want to thank Will Forte, Kristen Schaal, Rochelle Aytes, and Cynthia.
And we'd also like to thank Ken Paves and Christina Zilber for helping us out with our Hollywood Summer Glow Makeovers. Now, all of you here can work on your own glam look because you're going home with these Lorelei makeup brushes.
See, I got you the tote.
You got me the tote! Oh. And to care essentials with this Carlos by Carlos Santana tote. Available in 5 department stores.
Since it's Monday, we want to end the show with some goals we have for the week. All right, we got to set some goals. Babe, what are your goals for the week?
Don't take my husband for granted.
Mm. What else?
Hashtag, because he got me a tote. Hashtag, marital sex is good sex.
Hashtag no more ice cream.
Well, guess what? We'll see you back here tomorrow when Zendaya stops by. Oh,
make sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Instagram, okay?
See ya.
See ya.